Welcome back. It has been a while, hasn't it? Well, you know my name by now, so let's jump right in.
Wir haben die Treffpunktkoordinaten erreicht.
Empfangen ein Signal der Gläser. Aber irgendetwas stimmt nicht. Die Übertragung wird gestört. Leitstelle.
Die Klesan ist in Gefahr. Finden Sie sie so schnell wie möglich.
And with this,
Forschung läuft.
Cutscene concluded. We are starting to research afterburners. So we still have to find our sister ship, but right now I'm building a few more units. This mission got me some real headaches. It was, on my first try, I tried to just play it the way the game told me to, and let's just say that was quite embarrassing. And I lost about 1 or 2 hours of my life trying to do it the real way. So what does this all mean? Well, you see. First off, we are alone here, but I will move our mothership closer to those resources. You can see on the left, those brown points are asteroids and then dust clouds. And I'll move my military units together with some. If you remember the last mission, we found something in deep space, and now you have to find our sister ship, the Klesan, a research ship built by our clan, to find out what the hell we have found. Trouble is, we can't make contact with them. We have to search for the Klesan first. Now I start to mine resources in this mission and start building more of our cloaked corvettes, the VKS. Why, you ask? Well, you'll see. So about the let's play, I'll try to make the new episodes a bit faster than this month-long waiting period you had to endure. You one, two guys who are actually watching this shit. Oh, yeah. The Pathfinder AI messes up here. But, well, let's focus on those little fighters. Or, what should I do first now? Ah, yes, production. See, with our... We're coming too fast to the end with our resource units, and we have to not resource units, fleet units, our SE, our Schiffseinheiten, our ship units. Because of that, I have to destroy a few of my units. But the mild and slow way to regain some of the resources. And for this mission to work properly, the way I am intent to let it go, we'll need exactly 6 of the cloaked corvettes. Or, well, theoretically we could also build 12 of the cloaked fighters. Yes, exactly. Okay, just so we are clear, VKS or VKS is our normal corvette, built from either directly or coupled from 2 Wasal or Acolyte fighter jets. Space fighters, sorry, fighter jets. And the VJKS, the VJKS, the cloaked versions built together from our cloaked space fighters. And important to remember, those units don't actually have any weapons. They're easy targets. So first I save because I'm cautious and I don't want to lose all my progress like the last time I tried this mission. That was embarrassing. Luckily, through the magic of video editing, you don't have to suffer through those 50-60 minutes of me messing everything up and then losing hilariously. So anyway, here a close-up of our little cloak covers. As you can see, it's actually just two cloaked fighters coupled together. And yeah, it's kind of important to remember that you have to actually switch to cloaking first before you can send the fighters into enemy territory, or they will just be destroyed without being able to defend themselves. Also important to remember is those units are suicide bombers. They can destroy a unit up to their own size easily with one hit, but well, you lose your own unit with this. So this means the cloaked fighters are not that useful actually, but if you have a cloaked corvette at this point in the game, they are really useful because you can easily clear dangerous enemy corvettes. Here, closer look to what I mean. We go on cloaking mode, enemy ships, and then we'll cloak like and will look like mine layers or fighters. We could do this, but this is trouble because if the ships are too small, so this actually means the corvettes will decloak first and then cloak. Well, except for that one who was apparently too close to the other ones. Huh, weird. So, but back together. So what we can do now is going back to coupling and again. So another important thing to remember is you can order a small cloaked fighter to impersonate a corvette, but the other way around doesn't work. And over, and it's also important to remember you may can cloak your little cloak fighters and pretend to be corvettes, but you can't actually destroy corvettes with one hit like with the cloaked corvettes of your own. As you could see in the close-up, yes, we'll look like two Renegade Raiders now. Now we can send them before our mothership. A nice formation. Exact formation is not that important, since you know there are no weapons you have to focus your fire with. You just have to be careful enough not to accidentally ram more enemy units with your covers than absolutely necessary. I've noticed Delta formation works good for this because this way, if one of your corvettes hit a target, the chance of another of your cloaked corvettes blowing up is minimized. Oh, well, that's what I tell myself, but it sure looks nice, I think. Oh, yes, we are finding the mines now. A lot of mines in this mission. This is Minesweeper Homeworld Edition, and I really, really hate this. The only thing worse is escort missions, but we'll get into this sometime. Now we can just look at our units in flight and hope nothing goes wrong. Ha! Spoiler. Will be nothing going wrong with the cloaked units since the enemy mines ignore them. This is the entire reason why I did this. Sooner or later, our working ships will have depleted the resources in this mission, and then we'll can go on. So while we are closing in on the minefield, our first enemy ships. But what I wanted to say is there are essentially two methods to clear this mission. The first one is using light ships, like reconnaissance ships, to destroy the mines, using heavier ships to destroy the corvettes, and hoping not too many of your ships blow up while you clear the way for the Kleesan, who is somewhere. We don't know how, who, where. We don't know where it is yet. So, and now I demonstrate the start of the other method. Using your cloaked corvettes to destroy the mine layers, because the mine layers would otherwise just negate everything we could do with lightships. There is, as I'm just now thinking about, a third method, which could be said as a combination between this method and the other one I tried last time. Essentially using lightships to clear the mines while using your cloaky corvettes to destroy the enemy mine layers, like I am doing right here. And there goes the last one. But since there's no carrier ship replacing them in this mission, we have now cleared the first major obstacle for this mission. And because I'm paranoid, I'm of course saving this. I really don't want to do this again, even though it really was a success this time. When looking at command ship, our mother ship, the Kunlan, it's important to remember this will still change a lot. But just in case, I'm building a few more cloaked ships to clear possible obstacles still around. And I'm finally building another working ship here. And this is essentially, well, it's, I can send this one after I make sure it's actually cloaked, of course, and then I can send the fighter ahead while our other forces stay back and clear the resources, because we will need them later. So even though we are still in the beginning of the game right now, in the first third, I could say, it's still important to remember this is one of the first missions where you really have to start to use your brain, because Homeworld Cataclysm is not a game where you just have to fight through endless hordes of enemies. This is of course something that also happens, but it just involves you more, you could say, than most other RTS play games. You will have now noticed I have clicked on something and made it green instead of red. This was a function used to allow your ships to dock, get repaired, and just launch immediately after again. Nice if you're in a running battle, but sometimes you want to hide your small squishy ships from enemies and want to let them stay docked. So if you switch this thing to green, then in your docking manager, or system manager as it's also called here in the German translation, then all your little fighters and corvettes and working ships will just stay docked and out of harm's way. And this becomes important now, and this is why I just docked all my small little fighters and corvettes. Well, except for those, of course, because the VJKS, are still needed on the battlefront. But those ships can be cloaked, so they can just ignore all mines. And yeah, our little cloaked fighter is far ahead already, going to the rear sensor readings we're getting from there, and hopefully we'll finally can see the Klee-San at least, or at last, or both. Yeah, cloaked like enemy corvettes. Now they are looking like rocket corvettes. And spoiler, this is exactly what I will send them after. As you can see on the right, we have 95 out of 100 system ship units. So we are essentially full. We have all the fighters and corvettes we can build right now. So I sent my mother ship a bit farther ahead. And cutscene time.
Piraten haben die Klee-San in einem Minenfeld eingeschlossen. Wenn sie sich bewegt, wird sie von den Minen zerstört.
So, a short update on our situation. We have found the Klee-San, our missing research ship. Problem? There are even more mines. There are mines on the entire way to the ship and mines surrounding the ship. Ah, we can see the Klee-San. Finally. Yeah, that is the last ship built by the mother ship back in the Higaran home system. Remember, our clan, the Somtav, built 3 ships. This research ship, the Kuun-Lan, and another ship of the same class as the Kuun-Lan. And here we have the defenders, fighters, mines, and there are also a few corvettes parked around, but this won't be a problem right now. Instead, we'll sending more, making sure our cloaked corvettes are actually getting where they are supposed to be. Now, we're moving the command ship right next to the mines. Our working ships are still working on depleting the asteroids nearby.
Aber die Signale sind zu stark gestört. Wir müssen einen Vario-Jäger durch den Minengürtel schicken und eine Direktverbindung herstellen.
Now it looks like the game is telling us to actually use our little Vario fighter. Or a cloak fighter, which is of kind of funny because if you somehow didn't get the memo, then you're now getting this fact rubbed into your face. You can send a fighter right through the mines, the enemies, and nothing will happen. And the funny thing is, I'm actually right next to the Klee-San, but not close enough for the secret transmission the Klee-San is trying to get through. And now we're getting our secret encrypted transmission.
Wir müssen die Klee-San sofort befreien. Empfehlung: Räumen Sie die Minen mit Hilfe kleiner, schneller Schiffe aus dem Weg. Außerdem muss die Piratenflotte angegriffen und zerstört werden.
So a shitload of news, updated sensor manager, and we have a new research we can do. So what's new? Well, now we can see all the mines on our sensor manager. This is actually quite helpful, but at the same time also quite useless for most of the strange because newsflash. I tried it like I was told right now, use lightships to clear the mine and attack and destroy the pirate ships. But if you try both at the same time, you'll get your ass handed to you. So let's do this the smart way. And the smart way is using your command ship to just ram right through all mines in your way. And now, there's no fancy research we are getting to actually start. We need to build a new weapon module first. A bad day for miners. Now we have to actually build a weapons module to research weapons technology. Now we know there is not much resources left, so I just order my working ships to start repairing my mothership, and my motherships is ordered to just ram straight through all mines, like those six, for example. Yeah, slowly we're getting closer and closer. If we're smart, I would remember at this point I can actually use a shortcut to make time go faster, but just say I wanted to make sure not to lose my mothership if the mines do more damage than I anticipated. So while I'm trying to brute force my way through the minefields, the other rocket ships are there. Now we can repairing the damage, and the mines are coming. The mines are coming and impacting. While the mines are enough to destroy fighters and corvettes in one hit, and even frigates pretty fast if you had one right now, that is. Our command ship is hardier enough, like all really, really large ships like carriers and heavy cruisers. As long as you make sure to repair them, they can just walk right through minefields without getting impacted very much. Mines not working against large ships is kind of weird, but well, at least those mines are also seeking mines. You just have to get close enough, then they'll just automatically try to ram your ship. And here, I'm attacking a rating. Rocket corvette, still complete, silent mode. Just sitting there because the enemy AI doesn't know I'm there. So I just have to slowly creep closer and closer and hit and destroy it. So I forgot to mention, if you're wondering why we can see the mines now, well, remember the Klesan is a research ship. The Klesan used some sort of super scanner to decrypt the information channels of the mines, and now we can practically look into the telemetry of the minefield. And here you see why I keep my little ship stalked. Right now they could easily fight off those pirate fighters, but then there would be easy targets for the mines looking around. So at this point, our mothership and its anti-fighter guns are enough to slowly grind the enemy down without taking too much damage. Except of course if the enemy AI suddenly gets smart and hides away in the engine section, because then our guns can't do much. Well, at least the fighters take a little bit of damage. And ahead I see already the next part of the minefield. But first things first. Now our weapon module is online and we can research the next technology. Rocket launchers. This will give our Vassal fighters rockets. Every Vassal or Acolyte can then carry 2 missiles, and this is actually kind of neat, because this means essentially enemy corvettes become pretty much useless except in large numbers. Why? Well, if you say take 4 of your fighters and order them to attack an enemy corvette with missiles, then the corvette will instantly blow up. That's how powerful those missiles are. So if there are some really obnoxious rocket or enter corvettes or mine layer corvettes, from now on we don't have to suicide bomb them anymore, we can just build 4 cheap fighters for each and then send them ahead. Important to remember, however, the missiles the fighters are carrying aren't replenishable. You have to actually dock the fighters again, so the mothership or the carriers we can get later can actually replace the missiles. This of course gives our fighters their rollback, because right now it would be a lot of smarter to couple them together to get corvettes, because those VKS called those coupling corvettes have double, twice the amount of firepower and are a lot more durable, which makes them good anti-fighter screens or shred enemy fighters close to you like no man's business. Bad thing however is our corvettes are really really bad against enemy corvettes, especially specialized corvettes like, well, mine layers who can just drop mines, and your corvettes will be too slow in most cases to evade them. Or rocket corvettes who can just do the same our missile acolytes can do and blast your corvettes apart with a few hits. But now, thanks to rock, paper and scissor, we can just turn this around, send our acolytes after the enemy corvettes and our corvettes after the enemy fighters. Case closed. Now the real fun starts as soon as we get our own capital ships, but right now we are still brute forcing our way through an obnoxious minefield to get finally our research ship out of the way. So we have taken a bit damage, but with 4 worker ships simultaneously repairing us, this is not something we have to worry about. See, our research and missile launchers is close to finished, and we have about halfway. We are about halfway through. So you might think this mission is, except for the mines, rather relaxing and slow, but in truth we are on an invisible timer here, and as at a certain point a new pirate fleet complete with frigates will turn up, and those frigates with their really really dangerous iron beams can really fuck us up. There's no sugarcoating this. If we're taking too long, then we'll not only have to clear the way for the Kleesan, we have to also simultaneously fight an entire new fleet. Now this sounds interesting, because theoretically I could use my missile launchers to destroy them or damage them enough to so my worker ships could claim them for our fleet, but remember, we have only a certain amount of ship points we can use right now, and this includes frigates and other capital ships. So most likely what would happen is we would lose a lot of ships and resources and get maybe 1 or 2 iron frigates out of the deal. And here I have to spoiler a little bit. In the next mission, having slow ships can be deadly, so it would actually do the opposite of helping you right now to snatch those enemy ships. Besides, the ships is, the fleet is large enough. Even if you try to snatch as many ships as you can, you are essentially just paying resources to switch some of your ships against tyrannic greater ships. And, well, that's kind of bad. So, because of this stupid timer, we have now... We have to hurry up a little bit. Which is what I'm actually doing right now, because the last time I tried this, I didn't even move my command ship that much. I just set the coolant line next to the resources and called it a day. And just sent little squadrons of light ships into the minefield, like I was supposed to be doing. This of course didn't work out, and I lost a lot of little ships. Especially because, as you saw, the missile launchers are something we don't get right away in this mission. We get it a lot later instead. So here I try to target enemy fighter swarms. But then I say, well, that's this. And I send this little recon ship forwards. Because, yeah, and here you're seeing what happens if the enemy AI fucks up and sends the ships right where all the guns are. A lot of exploding goes on, but not on our side. Here, of course, I panic and start my own fighters, which is a bad idea in this situation, because if you're not in danger and you do this, what you're actually doing is give the enemy AI a new target, and sometimes it could happen that the enemy fighters and corvettes will suddenly attack you, slowly lining up fighters. Even more dangerous is ducking under enemy fire, because all your ships become super slow and easy targets, but sometimes it's still better than losing all of them. Here I'm trying to let them dock as fast as possible before more fighters and mines show up. And then I'll use my suicide bombers to get a few more corvettes out of the way before my main fleet arrives. So back to the timer thing. This invisible timer doesn't work the same all the time. I think it's connected to finding the Klesan. I have no concrete proof of this, but last time I sent a ship to the Klesan right away and started all this chain of little cutscenes. And right now we have about spent 27 minutes and a few seconds on this mission. And the last time I did this, well, at this point the pirate fleet already showed up. This time this didn't happen, and I'm guessing this is because I did a bit of prep work this time and started moving through the minefield and all that stuff before actually sending a ship ahead like the first time. So if you're asking yourself now, why did I build new reconnaissance ships? Well, this is... Those plucky little things are still quite good at clearing mines, and as I said, we have to hurry up a little bit, so I'm destroying more corvettes and sending little reconnaissance ships to try to destroy a few more mines before the mothership arrives. Now the problem here is there are still a lot of enemy fighters, not just corvettes. And those ships will just kind of patrol around. Normally not really that much of a problem, since my recon ships are a bit faster than the enemy fighters, but I have to carefully maneuver around them and then stay roughly at the same point for a while to attack the mines. So it can be a bit hairy since my recon ships are lightly armed. They have barely enough firepower to deal with a mine, even in a group of four. So they are practically helpless against enemy units. Except if you build them in such large numbers, that becomes ridiculous. But well, and here you see what would happen normally. We fire the mine, but the mine also comes to us and tries to hit us, but it doesn't help. On a second pass, we got the mine. So, three storyline mines are still there. Mines that have to be cleared, or the mission won't be flagged as complete. So we'll attack the second mine, and rocket corvette and fighters, everything swarms up to us. This means those four are dead. Sorry girls, I should have planned this better, but at least we know the positions of the other corvettes and can send our cloaked corvettes kill this. So, in the last gambit, I try to send my surviving reconnaissance units to the last two mines, but I'm not really sure this will actually work with so. Ah! And they start dying. Yeah, that was it. So, barely better than sending suicide units. So, my last two suicide corvettes will now be sent after many enemy corvettes, the most dangerous units. Fighters aren't really a problem. The Kunla can just lay waste to entire clouds of enemy fighters. But corvettes can be dangerous. And good. And the last corvette I can destroy before I have to build new units. And since we are cloaked, the enemy corvette just ignores us and flies away. So I guess we have to just wait until the enemy corvette reaches its start point. But on the other hand, the Kunlan has almost reached our sister ship, and I am now rerouting our mother ship to ram right straight through the last mines to clear them. And more enemy fighters. Now I'm thinking, should I? No, this time the enemy AI has really fucked up and sent the fighters first right next into the broadsides. Then it fucks up again by sending the fighters back from the safe region behind my engines and right back into the broadsides. But it looks like I need my fighters now, because there are a few. There's an obnoxious rocket corvette here. But problem found, problem solved. Missile and destroyed. Wow, it looks like four are actually a little bit overkill, but you never know, and you can always accidentally miss.
So,
and destroyed. Well, that was anticlimactic. Better let them dock fast, so they can get some missiles back. Now we are almost at the end of the mission. Luckily, the next video will be a lot shorter, since the mission right after this run is mostly story. Not much fighting. Well, you can fight if you want, but it's a losing proposition. And you will see why. But right now, we're finally arriving at the position of the last mines. Novus, like I am, still give a new movement order to be twice as sure as I am right now that we're getting close enough to the mines to attract them. And now we can see them in new space. And first mine hits us. Second mine hits us, and we have cleared. Our working ships repair the minor damage, and now we can even see the Klesan. Fine. Yeah, now we only have to get close enough to the Klesan, and we are done. Ah, finally reunited. Now we can finally find out what kind of strange artifact we have found in deep space. The Klesan goes alongside our ship. We're still repairing something. And this should be it. 8 fighters, 9 corvettes. Sounds about right. But at this point, I think there may be some mines close by, preventing the mission from finishing. This is of course most likely wrong, because the Klesan comes closer and closer and looks like it wants to dock right now. But to be sure, because I really don't want to stay around until the pirate fleet comes in, I'll move around my fighters a bit to look if we can find some lurking mines annoying us. Oh, and too late. Well, that was a waste of time. Turns out there wasn't anything in the way, it was just the game teasing me a bit with the Klesan super slow docking. Now we have to dock all the fighters again and the working ships, and then we can jump into hyperspace. The mission is finished. Well, that was a bit of work. Let's come back and look at the next mission, okay? Lipluini is finished.